is here on behalf of Lovely Warren. His name is Norman Jones, and he's the Commissioner of the Department of Environmental Services for the City of Rochester.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thank you for having me. On behalf of Mayor Warren, I'd like to thank the Rochester People's Climate Coalition for organizing the Rochester Park for Global Action. Mayor Warren recognizes the urgent need for action to address climate change and understands the impact that the city's concrete action can have on reducing greenhouse gas emissions. We just went through two amazing winters. I don't know if you can realize that. I feel the winter from a different perspective than most of you, because I'm responsible for clearing snow and ice. I've been doing it for over 30 years, and believe it or not, my hair was wet before last spring. And this place, to get a little started, it's kind of great. But what was unique about last winter? Last winter, we've seen a 200-year event in regards to what the conditions were. We've never had a winter where it was as cold as that. The month of February, the average temperature was 12.2 degrees. That was a minus 14, more than the actual average for 20 years of record heating. For the entire month of February, we've seen, mind you, six hours above freezing. Totally unheard of. The frost level. When here in Rochester, we measure things from a construction standpoint of how low do you go with your pipes? Your frost level is normally about 42 inches at the worst. Last year we had pipes freezing at 5 feet. So this is really something that I called you for, coming out and taking these steps just to bring action and acknowledge what's really happening in our world. Because if you don't see this happening in the environment, you're fooling yourselves. It's there, it's out there, it's happening, and I live it. In fact, cities are positioning themselves as the true U.S. leaders in combating climate change, making it clear that action is wanted, needed, and possible. The City of Rochester has made a clear commitment to take actions on climate change. As many of you know, we have taken the Climate Smart Communities Pledge, as well as the Joint Compact of Mayors on the same pledge. These commitments require us to assess our current carbon footprint, forecast business as usual emissions, and lay out a path to take meaningful action to reduce these emissions, as well as prepare for some of the inevitable impacts that climate change will have on our community. And we see these impacts of climate change on our community. It has a disparate impact on people who have the least ability to deal with that. So as we look at our urban landscape, we have to make sure that we position ourselves that this climate change doesn't have a negative impact on those who at least can afford to deal with it. Many of our city facilities have had energy efficiency lighting upgrades. We've had LED lighting in many of our city buildings. We're currently looking at converting all of our streetlights to LEDs, which will reduce our carbon footprint and save us. There's good business sense to reduce what your energy usage is, along with changing your carbon footprint. We're going to save probably about 50% on our energy purchases for streetlight by changing the LEDs. We began to incorporate renewable energy into our buildings. We have two two city facilities that has solar panels on it. When you go to our Rochester Public Market, the actual watershed has solar panels that actually helps reduce our energy load there, and also at our Arnett Library. And again, the next year, we work with the developer. Now, this is great news, you guys should be hearing a lot about it soon, where we're going to put together a 2-megawatt solar farm at a landfill. Now, mind you, a landfill that was listed with the EPA, that's now been delisted, now we found a useful for it, become now a solar farm that's going to produce 2 megawatts of energy. I started my career in government, working in environmental services as a city recycling coordinator, and this was back in 1988. Everybody remembers the barge to nowhere, everybody was up in arms about that. And really invoked a passion or something went off of me that just said, you know, let's go, let's do something, we have to do something, we have to save the planet, we have to save this $5. And not many folks were with me at that time. So to have a group like this inspire people here on a Sunday afternoon, you've been doing something else. But you're here now, and we talk about climate change. We have folks in Paris, over 196 nations in Paris talking about climate change. It is real, and you're here. Join us at the City of Rochester as we try to move forward, as we move forward to make a difference in the lives of all cities, all the citizens of the City of Rochester, and be a beacon and a benchmark for other cities above. I thank you, I encourage you, I applaud you.